Hello everyone, welcome to my e-learning session of speed control of an induction motor, which is the topic of subject basic electrical engineering. Speed control of three-phase induction motor. A three-phase induction motor is practically a constant speed motor like a DC shunt motor, but the speed of DC shunt motor can be varied smoothly just by using simple rheostats. This maintains the speed regulation and efficiency of DC shunt motor. But in the case of three-phase induction motor, it is very difficult to achieve the smooth speed control. And if the speed control is achieved by some means, the performance of the induction motor in terms of its power factor, efficiency, etc. get adversely affected. As we know that the NR, that is rotor speed, is equals to 1 minus s into ns, where ns is synchronous speed, and the value of synchronous speed is ns is equals to 120 f upon p. Therefore we get NR is equals to 120 f upon p 1 minus s. This is the equation number 1. From equation number 1, it is clear that the motor speed can be changed by a change in frequency f, a number of poles p, and the slip s. Now, this is a classification of speed control methods. We have 5 types of speed control method. First one is pole changing method. Second one is stator voltage control method. Third one is supply frequency control method. Fourth is rotor resistance control method, and fifth is slip energy recovery method. The pole changing method is again subdivided into 3 categories. First is multiple stator windings, second is method of consequent poles, and third one is poles amplitude modulation. Now first is pole changing method. The pole changing method is one of the main method of speed control of an induction motor. This method of controlling the speed by the pole changing is used mainly for cage motor only, because the cage rotor automatically develop a number of poles. The method is called the pole changing method for controlling the speed. A continuous smooth speed control is not possible by this method. So they are known as multiple stator winding, method of consequence poles, and pole amplitude modulation. Here the pole changing method is divided into these 3 categories. Now first is multiple stator winding. In this method, instead of one winding, 2 separate stator windings are placed in the stator core. The windings are placed in the stator slots only, but are electrically isolated from each other. Each winding is divided into coils to which pole changing with consequent poles facilities provided. So the giving supply to one of the 2 windings and using switching arrangement, 2 speeds can be achieved. Same is true for other stator winding. So in all 4 different speeds can be obtained. The various limitations of this methods, first is can be applied to only square cage rotor. That means this method is only applied in square cage motor. The second is smooth speed control is not possible, only step changes in speed are possible. Next is 2 different stator windings are required to be worn, which increase the cost of the motor, and it is complicated from the design point of view. So this method is the speed control of less efficient and more costly. The next one is consequent poles method. In this method, connections of stator windings are changed with the help of simple switching. Due to this, the number of stator poles get changed in the ratio of 2:1. Hence, either of 2 synchronous speeds can be selected. Consider the pole formation due to the single phase of 3-phase winding. The figure below shows the single phase of a stator winding, which consists of 4 coils. The coils are divided into 2 groups. They are named as first group is AB and the second group is CD. Now, third method is the pole amplitude method. The basic disadvantage of the other methods, which is non-availability of smooth speed control, is estimated by this method. The ratio of two speeds in this method needs not be necessarily 2:1. So, the motors designed for speed changing based on the pole amplitude schemes are known as PAM motors, that mean pole amplitude modulation motors. Now, the second method of the speed control is stator voltage control method. This method is used to control the speed of an induction motor. The speed of a three-phase induction motor can be controlled by varying the stator voltage. The voltage is varied until the torque is required by the load is developed at the desired speed. The torque developed is proportional to the square of the supply voltage and the current is proportional to the voltage. So, the reduce the speed, the value of voltage is also reduced, and as a result, the torque developed by the motor is reduced. The example of this method is fan load. The next one is variable frequency control method. The speed of an induction motor can be controlled by varying the supply frequency. As we know that the synchronous speed NS is equals to 120 F upon P and the EMF induced in the stator E1 is equals to 4.44 kW1 F phi T1. Therefore, if the supply frequency is changed, induced EMF is also changed. So, the variable frequency supply is obtained by the following converters. The first is voltage source inverter, second is current source inverter, and third one is cycloconverters. Next is rotor resistance control method. This is also an important method of controlling the speed of an induction motor. The speed of wound induction motor can be controlled by connecting an external resistance in the rotor circuit. The larger the value of resistance, larger will be the value of slip at which the maximum torque occurs. So, by rotor resistance control method, the speed control is provided by the rated speed to the lower speed. This is very simple method of speed control. The example of this method is fan, pump drivers, etc. The next one is slip energy recovery method. The slip energy recovery method is the main method of controlling the speed of an induction method. In the rotor resistance control method, the slip power in the rotor circuit is wasted as I square R losses during the low speed operation. The efficiency is also reduced. The slip power from the rotor circuit can be recovered and fed back to the AC source so as to utilize it outside the motor. So the overall efficiency of the drive system can be increased. The figure below shows the connection and method of recovery, the slip energy and power recovery of the induction motor. The basic principle of slip power recovery is to connect an external source of the EMF of the slip frequency of the rotor circuit. The slip energy recovery method provides the speed control of a slip ring induction motor below the synchronous speed. The smoothing reactor is provided to smoothen the rectified current. The output of the rectifier is then connected to the DC terminal of the inverter. The inverter inverts the DC power into AC and feeds it back to the AC source. So, this method of speed control is used in large power applications where the variation of speed over a wide range involve a large amount of slip power. Thank you everyone for watching my video.